Oh, I know y'all ain't fucking miss me, but I'm motherfucking here, bitches. Guys, we got my guy right here. Introduce yourself.
It's your boy, Flip the Script, South Norwalk, Connecticut. Hula Gang, Warlord.
And make sure you watch that first episode that me and Tim did on our first episode. This is the year now that my show's been on, so I want to reconnect with people that I've been doing my episode, that I did an episode with, see how they going, and reconnect with them. So how you doing, boo?
Good, man. Living.
Got a lot of cigarettes. I don't know if it's a sad day, a cold day. The president, we got a new president, and we don't know if we got a president. We don't know what might be going on. But at the end of the black community right now, especially Connecticut, Hartford, Connecticut, New Britain, what is it? Let's scream it out. What's everything? Bridgeport, New Haven. Meriden, Danbury, damn, whatever, whatever hood you from, you get what I'm saying? We gotta bring it back together. There's a lot of shooting going on. I don't know if niggas dropping off guns in the hood, but niggas is shooting around this bitch. How was it over there?
3 weeks ago, out here, my little cousin. I had to carry the casket 3 weeks ago, man. It was real. Yeah, it's real ugly out here right now, man.
It's real ugly. If somebody can DM me the Juicy on IG and let me know what the fuck is the issue with, because at the end of the day, we all think we kings and queens and we all want to come up. But if we kill and we fuck each other over, ain't nobody making it from Connecticut. The hate is going to kill us all. The hate is going to
kill us. The hate been killing us, man. The hate been killing us. The hate, the bullshit, it been killing.
You think that anybody will succeed in Hartford? Like, people are succeeding on the low, but let me not tell you that. Like, people got their own businesses. People are doing what they need to do. But far as somebody big coming from Connecticut or something lit coming from Connecticut, do you think that that is possible with everybody, all these chiefs and no, you know, unity over here? It's always a chief somewhere, you know, that pop out of the dust. You get what I'm saying? It's like... It's always got like, you be thinking you doing good, and then there's always a chief that come out of nowhere. You get what I'm saying? What do you think? Do you think it's somebody, like, do you think it's hope for Connecticut, far as, you know?
I think eventually, yeah, right now, no. But it's a lot of people that I personally met. I've been doing this a long time, doing shows. I done did shows up in Hartford. I met you in Hartford at a show. I met people all over Connecticut. And it's a lot of artists that could potentially put Connecticut on. Like, right now. Why they not on? Why it's not happening? I have no clue. But it's a lot of
You think that there's a lot? Well, let me start. What I think. I'ma say it. Fuck it. I'm about to ask you a question. I'm about to say this shit. I think that there's a lot of fucking gatekeepers in Hartford, Connecticut, and I think that there's a lot of niggas that know how to get there, but want to invest so much in themselves, even though that they're not gonna win ever in life, that they'll rather waste that money on themselves versus than help somebody knowing that they can get there. I feel like the promoters and the DJs want more than what an artist should have to give. If your music is fire, it should be played. It shouldn't be no more than that. I believe that it's a lot of fraudulent shit going on in the industry that motherfuckers want you to worship them before they play a song. Your shit could be the hottest shit out here, but if they don't like you, they're not gonna give you a spin, they're not gonna give you a view, and they don't give a fuck. And these niggas is average-ass niggas. These niggas is, like, these motherfuckers is old-ass niggas, all right? Probably 45, 49, 50 and up, all right? Let it go and let your people eat. It's kind of sad and depressing at this point, but then it's like people getting their bread. I'll give it to Hartford and people in Connecticut, Bridgeport, everybody. We some hustlers because we know how to eat regardless. You get up this talent.
Yeah, we
go ahead.
H left. I'm gonna tell you something I did. Me and my cousin, he just went upstairs. He's my business partner, and he's also our
producer.
You need another drink. But what we did, we put out a bunch of mixtapes together, a trilogy. We put out another mixtape, right? Then we're gonna need a mixtape. It was an album. Came out last year on my birthday, last January. And instead of us just rocking on it, we put all of the young boys, females too, everybody from around that we knew was hot. We let them shine on it. And we basically just hosted it. Because we know we getting older, but we know the know-how or how to do it what somebody didn't do for us. So we basically let them rock all over it. And we pushed the hell out of it. Now we could have said, hell, you feature on my shit, but this my shit. Nah, we put it out as a crew. We put it out as a team, and we pushed them artists. If more people did that, like what you just said is like, yo, people are getting older, whatever, whatever. Stop thinking about yourself. If you around for the culture, if you around for this, then let somebody else shine. If you can see something in that person, like, yo, I'd rather take the credit for somebody saying, all right, I'm here at this plateau, and he helped me do it, rather than be, I'm here at this plateau, and these niggas with me. Nah, my time came and went.
I was a part of it, and that means I can make it happen again. I got the fucking sauce. And people can't understand that. Niggas want to be making the sauce and tasting the sauce and licking the sauce. And, you know, niggas is on some P. Diddy shit. And that's what it is.
Yeah.
Niggas is on the Ciroc, man. All these niggas is on the Ciroc, man. Everybody's on the Ciroc. You get what I'm saying? And it's kind of sad, you know? Even the people at a local level, it's like you haven't been nowhere other than your state. Let's open it up and let's support each other. You get what I'm saying? Let's see what we can do, you know? But it ain't gonna happen unless we have unity in our community. This is very important. You know, we gotta find that kind of unity. So